looking for supplies?
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
Ooh, we've got 8. Okay, this is what I have. That's better. It's expensive. 38, 276. It's a lot better though. Bought it. This crap is really expensive. Firestorm. Oh. Yeah, it's not as good as what we have. Okay. Of course I'm gonna sell the armor we have. Look at that. It's better in everything. Awesome. So I'm gonna sell the Scorpion 5.
Looking for supplies?
Not really, but...
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
Sell this armor. I can sell this too. Cryo Explosive 4. And these Omni tools. I'm gonna leave them for now. Fusion 4. Where's my armor? Oh, Scorpion 5. Eh, it's not even that much money. Look at that. Oh well. Still got plenty of money. We definitely upgraded though. down here. Engineer Adams probably doesn't have anything new to say.
Something I can do for you, Commander.
Nope.
Carry on, Adams.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Tally.
It feels like we're getting near the end, doesn't it, Shepard? With Saren, I mean.
Already? Well, I hope so.
It won't be much longer. One way or another, it'll all be over soon.
You'll find the conduit before he does. I know you will. You have to. And after this is all over, when my pilgrimage ends, and I go back to my own people, I'll be proud to say I was a part of it.
An important part.
We couldn't have done this without you, Tally.
You've been good to me. A lot of people treat Quarians like second-class citizens. They just want us to go back to our fleet and disappear. But you've treated me just like everyone else on your crew. Like an equal. That means a lot, and it says something about you. Whatever happens, I just want to say thank you for that.
You're definitely welcome.
I'm gonna miss you when you go back to your own people, Tally.
That won't happen for a while yet. I'll be right here anytime you need me.
We've asked her all this stuff. I just want to see if there's anything different. I'm probably gonna skip through this.
I want to know more about the pilgrimage.
Oh, I didn't.
When my people reach maturity, but no shit, we This is presented as a gift to the captain of the respective ship we wish
to talk about something.
Like what?
The Geth I meant to hit.
I want
to
know more about the Geth.
I doubt I can tell you anything you don't already. All I know is the story of their origins. Yeah. What they were when we created them.
I
want
to talk about something else.
Like what?
I should go.
Like about me going.
See you later.
I want to talk about me leaving. Oh, wait. Is that what I wanted to do? Oh, they both go here. I'm gonna find my way to the medical bay. So I guess it is back up here. That goes there too, alright. I want to activate... It's through here, these side passages. I always forget these are here. Oh, we auto-loaded. Don't know why. There's nothing here to even see. These are my quarters. I mean auto-saved. Dr. Chakwas usually doesn't have anything else to say.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
Or anything new to say? Nope.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Time to talk to Liara.
Commander, are you coming to check up on me?
I was worried.
You look much better. How are you feeling?
Dr. Chakwas assures me I am going to be fine. I was impressed with her knowledge of Asari physiology.
This is the same conversation we had. Of course, the last time she wasn't feeling well. She's the best.
You're in good hands. Dr. Chakwas knows what she's doing.
I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
Tell me more about you. If this is... I might be skipping through this, I don't know.
Maybe we could pick up where we left off. You were telling me about your interest in the Protheans.
Actually, I think I was talking about my interest in you, and making a fool of myself in the process. As I said, I am not used to dealing with people, especially humans. I did not really know much about your species when we first met, Shepard. I found it hard to take humanity seriously. Your kind always seemed so rushed and high-strung.
What about now?
Has your opinion changed at all?
It has. I have been watching you and your crew. It has taught me a lot about your species. You humans are creatures of action. You pursue your goals with an almost indomitable determination. It is an admirable trait, but also an intimidating one.
Intimidating?
You're scared of us?
Unfortunately, the rest of the galaxy sees humanity as something of a bully.
What?
You run over anyone in your path to get what you want. It is up to people like you to change their minds, Shepard.
I'm trying.
I'm doing the best I can, Liara.
There is a reason the Council chose you to become a Spectre. They saw something special in you. The best of what humanity has to offer. I looked into your history. I know what you did during the Blitz. It was a remarkable display of courage and heroism.
You looked that up?
Why are you so interested in me?
I wanted to know more about you. To understand what made you into the woman you are. There is something compelling about you, Shepard.
She, like, responded kind of shyly about that. I want to believe that.
Are you sure you're interested in me, or is it my visions of the Protheans?
I admit, your connection to the Protheans had something to do with my initial interest, but it has grown beyond that. My interest in you, however, is strictly professional.
Hey!
I want to make that clear. It is obvious that you and Lieutenant Alenka already have some type of relationship. I would not want to come between you.
Oh, no. Oh crap, I messed up. This is the one part where I might want to play that part over, guys. There was an autosave, I think that's after I talked to him. How do I tell her no? Crap, I messed up by telling him that. I thought I was talking about something else. Which option is the best? He's special. I'm taken by him? Private? There's no... I don't know any good answer here. I'll choose this, but you're female?
That wouldn't happen.
Oh, crap.
I'm only interested in men.
We Asari are monogendered, Commander. Male and female do not have any real meaning for us. We do, however, have maternal instincts. So perhaps we would fill what you consider a female role. I apologize if I have made you uncomfortable, Commander. As I said, I wouldn't want to come between you and Lieutenant Delenko.
Oh no, reverse, reverse.
Maybe it would be best if we spoke about something else.
No. I've already talked to her about this stuff.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
No, no.
I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
I just wanted to talk.
Fair enough. What did you want to talk about?
Crap.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Let me read this codex. And I'm reloading this sucker. Asari religion. The pantheistic mainstream Asari religion is Siari, which translates roughly as all is one. The faithful agree on certain core truths. The universe is a consciousness. Every life within it is an aspect of the greater whole, and death is a merging of one's spiritual energy back into the greater universal consciousness. Siaris don't specifically believe in reincarnation. They believe that spiritual energy returned to the universal consciousness upon death will eventually be used to fill new mortal vessels. Siari became popular after the Asari left their homeworld and discovered their ability to meld with nearly any form of life. This ability is seen as proof that all life is fundamentally similar. Siari priestesses see their role as promoting unity between the disparate shards of the universe's awareness. Before the rise of Siari pantheism, Asari religions were as diverse as their political opinions. The strongest survivor of those days, is the monotheistic religion worshipping the goddess Athame. Like the Asari, the goddess cycles through the triple aspects of maiden, matron, and matriarch. Very good. Now, what's interesting, they've lifted some aspects of Wiccan and perhaps pagan culture in general. The Athame, I think it's spelled the same. It's actually a knife used in ritual. Not in any violent way, of course. It's used to stir wine and stuff like that. It's just used in ritual to, you know, mostly to mix things, and you would gesture with it, call forth the, you know, gods and goddesses, that kind of thing. So, only in this, Athame is the name of the goddess. And the whole thing with Wicca, at least, is the whole, it's not maiden, matron, and matriarch. It's maiden, mother, and crone, I believe, are the three phases of being female. Now, since I've screwed everything up, Hopefully you forgive me, guys, because I did not know what I was saying when I told him that. God, man, word gets around quickly. Auto save. Quick save. Is this... wait, Normandy command deck? Now this is before I talk to him, right? I'm gonna run. Let's have Joker say his little thing again. Yeah, I had no idea what I was really saying there, and yeah, I just screwed everything up.
Hey, Commander, next time we touch down, let's try not to park the ship in a colony of mutant zombies.
I have to go.
Alright, see ya.
Okay, so we're done here, and we're gonna go run. Navigator Presley doesn't have anything new to say. Oh. I always forget this door doesn't open by itself. Now, I could just talk to her first, but let's do him the right way here. Sounded kind of wrong.
We haven't had time together since our last chat. A lot was said when we talked.
Something to add, Lieutenant, or are you just breaking?
Sorry, not sure where I stand. You seem a bit,
Someone? You're referring to her.
There's a lower deck rumor that she's a very interesting lady. To my, tastes, but, I never claimed to be big on alien culture.
Can I still ask him if he's jealous?
You seem awfully worried.
It's just that we don't have much downtime these days. I like being around you, but I don't want to take up your personal time.
Okay, now I'm afraid saying either of these two will be encouraging. I know that one doesn't mess up. Now, when I said this, it's not like that. I meant you're not taking up my personal time. So,
I'm tired of this, Lieutenant. I don't care if you have a problem with me chatting up Liara. It's none of your business.
That's right. Tell him.
Yes, Commander. Just had some static on my comm. Got some signals wrong. It won't happen again.
Kinda didn't want to tell him that. It's rude, but...
Anything you need, Commander?
Nope.
We'll talk another time, Lieutenant.
Commander?
Haha. Thank the Lord for... oh, this crap. Oh, I gotta buy that again. Yeah, I'm gonna get this stuff and I gotta buy that armor again. So, see you on the flip side. Okay, quick little thing. I don't know if I messed up and bought her heavy armor or it's just not here. She has Scorpion 5. Here's Scorpion 4. Oh, wait. Is this it? Oh, that's, no, this wasn't it. It was so much better in everything. That's heavy armor. Can't even use it. Yeah, see, Scorpion 4, not as good. It's not here. I don't know if it's a random thing or I bought the heavy armor. I have to go back and look, so I'm just gonna sell a bunch of crap here. Okay, other than that, I've done everything the same. I've talked to Garrus, Rex, Tally, Ashley, and have, done everything the same. I'm just gonna save, just so... because things seem to be okay right now, that I didn't mess anything up.
Commander, are you coming to check up on me?
Looked like she had a little wink there at the beginning, didn't it?
You look much better. How are you feeling?
Dr. Chakwas assures me I am going to be fine.
You're in good hands. Dr. Chakwas knows.
I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
Maybe we could pick up where we left off. You were telling me about your interest in the Protheans.
Actually, I think I did not really know much about your species when we first met, Shepard. I found it hard to take humanity seriously.
Has your opinion changed at all?
It has. I have been watching you and your crew. You humans are creatures of action. You pursue your goals with an almost indomitable...
You're scared of us?
Unfortunately, it is up to people like you to change their minds, Shepard.
I'm doing the best I can, Liara.
There is a reason the Council chose you. I looked into your history. I know what you did during the Blitz. It was a remarkable display of courage and heroism.
Could have asked.
You didn't need to go behind my back. I would have told you whatever you wanted to know.
I apologize, Commander. After our last conversation, I was afraid I would say something stupid again.
She got so nervous.
I wanted to know more about you. To understand what made you into the woman you are.
Shy.
There is something compelling about you, Shepard.
Are you sure you're interested in me? Or is it my visions of the Protheans?
I admit, your connection to the Protheans had something to do with my initial interest. But it has grown beyond that. You intrigue me, Shepard. But I was not sure if it was appropriate to act on my feelings. I thought there might already be a relationship between you and Lieutenant Alenko.
Crap. It's not serious? I guess?
The lieutenant and I are just friends.
Right, good.
Nothing more.
My mistake, then. I am not as adept at understanding human relationships as I thought.
Phew.
But what about us, Shepard? Is there a mutual attraction, or was I wrong about that, too?
I am attracted to you.
No, you are right. There is something between us.
I knew it. And I knew you felt it too. But does this not seem rather strange? Why do I feel so close to you? We have only known each other a short time. We are from two different species. We have almost nothing in common. This makes no sense.
It doesn't have to. Just roll with it, baby.
These things never make sense. They just happen and we get swept up in the storm.
You make it sound so chaotic, so dangerous.
So exciting. That's why it's fun. I don't want to scare her away by saying that's what's fun. I'll protect you.
I'll keep you safe.
I am not looking for a protector. This is all a bit overwhelming. I am not used to this. You. I need some time.
You started it. I understand.
Take all the time you need, Liara. I'll be here.
Thank you, Shepard. Let's just talk about something else for now.
Now, if this seems familiar, I'm gonna space through it.
Do you know why Benezia joined up with Saren?
Benezia was swept up in events beyond her control and...
I think she said this.
She fell under the spell of indoctrination and became part of the very thing she wanted to stop. But I will remember and honor how she lived, not how she died. My mother was strong, kind, and beautiful. And now she is gone.
I'm sorry.
Are you gonna be okay?
You are kind to ask, Shepard. I do miss her, and I grieve for what happened to her. But I will not let my grief interfere with what we are trying to accomplish.
And the Asari culture.
I'd like to know more about the Asari.
We were the first species to discover the Citadel. We were instrumental in forming the Council, and we always strive to be the voice of peaceful cooperation in galactic disputes. My people believe we are all part of a single galactic community. Each species contributes something to the greater whole. Although we seek to understand other species, it seems few of them seek to understand us. The galaxy is filled with rumors and misinformation about my people.
Rumors?
Like what?
Most of the inaccuracies are centered around our mating rituals. My species is monogendered. Male and female have no real meaning for us. We still require a partner to reproduce. This second parent, however, may be of any species and any gender.
How is that possible? I think she said this, or we read it in Codex, either one. I'm not sure, so I'm just gonna let it play out.
I don't understand. Your species can mate with anyone?
Mating is not quite the proper term, not as you understand it. Physical contact may or may not be involved, but it is not an essential element of the union.
I remember
the
that.
The true connection is mental. Our physiology allows us to meld with other beings. We can touch the very depths of their minds. We explore the genetic memory of their species. We share the most basic elements of their individual and racial identities. We then pass these traits on to our daughters. It is how we learn to grow as a species and how we develop a greater understanding of other races.
What about the other parent?
What happens to your partner after the union?
Every relationship is different.
Yeah.
Others can be more long-term. Sometimes an Asari and her partner will stay together for many decades.
Do you know who Matriarch Benezia chose as her partner?
She rarely spoke of her partner. Though I know my father, if you want to use that term.
Benezia never told
union
you...
Union with... Asari... I am what is sometimes... It is possible Benezia's partner was embarrassed by their union. She may have been too ashamed to publicly acknowledge me as her offspring.
Maybe she wanted to...
You might be right. Benezia never spoke of her partner. Many Asari raise their children alone, particularly if the father species is short-lived. Often the partner will pass on long
I should
before.
Go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
How rude. So, yeah, we read about religion. Okay. Think we're done talking about to our crew.
I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
I just wanted to talk.
Of course, Shepard. What did you want to talk about?
It's the same stuff anyway.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
Okay, good. I feel like we've moved forward to a good place here. She's gonna take time to figure out what the hell's going on. Wait, I'm going down. No, I want to go up, which is not the elevator. So weird how... I mean, the elevator should go to all decks, I feel. I'm sure there's a reason, I guess, in case systems failure and the lifts don't work, we still need to get to the bridge. But then again, if you're down in engineering, you can't. Alright, so next episode we're going somewhere. Undetermined. I do not know yet. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.